if you woke up with the third lip on your newly triangular mouth, what would you do with it? I already know, chat. I already know 1000%. I'm starting an OnlyFans for my mouth. What were you teased about most as a child, chat? As a child, we'll say like when you're like 10. I'll say people said that I, like, they would make fun of my freckles a lot. Or my forehead being big. People also made fun of me, because I had peach fuzz on my upper lip. And so that's like, I was super embarrassed about it. And I already told you guys that, like, I'm Italian, so I get a little bit of hair right here. So I take care of it, right? Like, I get it waxed. I might even get just laser hair removal so I don't ever have to deal with it again. But what's it called? And so kids will make fun of me for that. So what? That's normal. Well, I know, but as a little girl, I felt like a little boy, you know? Because, like, people were, like some people would notice if they got, like, if people got really close, I would go like this and stuff because I was really embarrassed. Have you ever seen, like, little Greek girls or little Italian girls? Like, they just have, like, a little bit, you know? And it's, you know, it is what it is. You're so young that, like, you didn't take care of it yet, you know? You didn't even shave your legs yet, so... So people made fun of me for that, and I hated it, but now I don't care. I tell everybody. I'm like, so what? I grow a little bit of hair on my upper lip, and I take care of it. You know, I don't grow, like, a scrappy beard or nothing. Like, I don't have, like, if you touch my lip, it's not scrappy. I just have a little peach fuzz. That's all. See? No one would ever know. Okay, so let me tell you something, chat. So you know Farrah from Teen Mom? You know her? English girl named Fiona. So she plucked her daughter's eyebrows. Because her daughter's eyebrows, I think she had a unibrow or something. And she got in a lot of trouble for it. A lot of trouble. But honestly, like, if my little kid had a little mustache, I think I would help them out. If you woke up with the third lip on your newly triangular mouth, what would you do with it? I already know, chat. I already know 1000%. I'm starting an OnlyFans for my mouth, chat. And I'm selling butthole pictures, but it's low-key my mouth. I mean, I'm already pretty good at it. Ready, chat? Nigga, the cops outside. Lock up the house. I used to do that for my friend all the time and she died laughing. I don't know why. That's my butthole face. Nobody on Twitch is famous. Besides maybe Ninja and like T-Pain and Soulja Boy. Logic. None of them got famous from Twitch though. XQC? No, he's not famous though. Because if I go down the street and ask my neighbor, hey, who's XQC? He has no fucking clue. You know what I mean? XQC's famous on Twitch, absolutely. Abso-friggin-lutely. We go to TwitchCon? Oh my gosh, he needs security, all sorts of stuff, you know what I mean? Absolutely. Like, if you go to the, like, if you go to a restaurant and you're able to sit there throughout the whole thing without people bugging you, I don't think you're famous. I think somebody who's famous is somebody who leaves their house and no matter where they go, people are like, oh my gosh, you're so-and-so. Whether or not it's like a lot, you know, but like everybody's noticing who they are. Okay, this isn't a philosophical question, but I'm gonna tell you guys something really dumb right now, okay? So I'm like afraid of the sky, chat. I don't like looking at the sky. It kind of like creeps me out lately. I don't know why. Is that weird? Like when I look at the sky, I get like scared. I just think the sky moving and shit, it just like creeps me out. Them things can't breathe. I forgot to take my birth control again. So my boobs got bigger, okay? Don't hate on me. Don't be weirdos. Don't talk about it. Don't be a weirdo. Don't be... I can't breathe. At least I have that problem. Unlike you, sir. Your pants be freaking baggy. You're over here like this with your pants. Man, I wish my pants would stay up, but they won't stay up because my dog is too goddamn small. Oh, okay, so I want to get my boobs done, chat, right? okay, so don't take me as some random bimbo, like every other bimbo out there, you know, like blonde-haired bimbo. Like, actually, like, hear me out here. Like, we're having a mature conversation. Don't be like, oh my God, Dan's talking about her boobs. Like, she's like a typical blah, blah, blah. Okay. So I'm gonna draw a picture. This might be weird, but okay. So this is the problem. I'm getting breast surgery eventually. Not right now. This is the problem I have. So I went in to get a consultation, y'all. So like basically, how do I describe it? Like, so like say this is the side of a boob. Like this is a regular boob, right? The side of a boob. Okay. So my problem is, that was actually freaking phenomenal, chat. Look at that tit. That was nice. That was nice. Okay, so that's like a normal side profile. Here is a saggy boob profile, right? Okay, that was not the best, but here's like a saggy boob profile. This is where I'm at, chat. I'm right. Does that make sense? Does that make sense? So like when I put on a bra, it like lifts them up and there's this like weird like space right here, you know, like. So he told me, he's like, you don't have sagging problems. He's like, but all your tissue, all your fat tissue is stored down here. So basically, chat, all my fat's down here, when in like normal people, their fat is everywhere. So I want to get a fake boob so my boob can, so this can come out like this. Well, so it starts with gravity, right? Gravity takes them down and then your fat starts falling down to the bottom of it. All right, I'm gonna take off, y'all. Thank you guys so much for hanging out today. I gotta go work out now, unfortunately. I wish I didn't have to work out, but I gotta go work out. All right, bye guys, thank you.